My name is Enrique Torres, and I'm from a small town in Mexico. The town's name is Atolinga, and it's in the state of Zacatecas. Today I'm going to explain how to play the game, the My Cosmic Number Puzzle. At the present time, July 2013, we only have the games available for the Android system. Later we will have the games for the Apple system. Now these puzzles were originally found inside the Mayan pyramids, and they were lost for over 1300 years, and the originals were inscribed in solid gold plates. Now someday in the future, we hope to show them to the whole world, but for now we want to teach you how to play the games. Now there are more than one type. We will show you how to play the 9x9 version of the game, which is this one. Later in other videos, we will show you how to play the 10x10 version. Now today, we'll be showing you how to play with the numbers you are most familiar with in school. The numbers used are from 0 to 9. Now in different puzzles, any of these numbers can be used. To start with, check to see if the puzzle uses 1 to 9 or 0 to 8. As you can see, this one uses numbers 0 all the way up to 8. Now to solve a Mayan cosmic puzzle, you must put a number from 0 to 8 in each spot of an empty box. Now each box will have, when completed, a two-digit number. Each number must appear only once in each spot of each horizontal row as well as in each vertical column. This puzzle uses the number 0 to 8 in two-digit combinations in such way that each first digit only occurs once in any row or column, and each second digit only occurs once in any row or column, and each two-digit combination only occurs exactly once in any puzzle. Now a hint is to find the rows or columns that need the least amount of blanks to fill in and start with them. Now first, I start with the row or column with the least amount of blanks in it. Now for example, let's see. This row only has two blanks in it, and most of the other ones, now this column only has two blanks in it. Let's start with one of these. Now we'll start with the left number, and we'll see that from on this column we have 7, 3, 2, 5, 8, 6, and 0, and we are missing a 1 and a 4. Now we have to check on which one of these blanks on the left number the 1 goes here or the 4. Now we go across on this row and we see that on the left numbers we have a 1, so a 1 cannot go here, so a 4 must go there. Now obviously the number 1 is going to go at the bottom. Now we go to the right number and we see we have a 4, 6, 2, 3, 7, 1, and 5, and we are missing a 0 and an 8. So we go across on this row and we see that on this number we have an 8 already on the right number, so an 8 cannot go here, so a 0 must go there. And the 8 that's missing goes at the bottom. Now we go to another row, this one with only two blanks, and we'll start with the left number on this box, and we see we have 8, 0, 7, 1, 3, 2, and 6, and we're missing a 5 and a 4. But if we go up and down on this column, we see that we already have a 4 on these left numbers. So a 4 cannot go here, and a 5 goes there. Now with the right number, we check the other right numbers on this row, and we have 5, 8, 0, 1, 6, 3, and 7, and we are missing a 2 and a 4. Now we go up and down on this column, we see we already have a 2 on the left numbers, on the right numbers, so a 4 must go here. Now we go to this blank, and we go with the left number, and we already have an 8, 0, 7, 5, 1, 3, 2, and 7, meaning 6, We are missing a 4. Now with the right numbers, we check, we see we have 5, 8, 0, 4, 1, 3, I mean 6, 3, and 7. So we are missing a 2. Now we look for the rower column with the least amount of blanks and continue. And we'll go with this one. And we see that up and down on this column we have on the left numbers 6, 5, 4, 3, 7, 0, and 8. We're missing a 2 and a 1. But here, we go to this row and we see that on the left numbers we already have a 2. So a 2 cannot go here, so it must be a 1. And down here, this is the 2. Now we go to the right number, and we have 2, 4, 1, 7, 5, 3, and 8. We're missing a 0 and a 6. So we go to this row, and we check the right numbers. And here we have a 2, so a 2 cannot go here, so it must be a 6. Now we check this number and see which one's missing. And we see we have 8, 3, 5, 7, 1, 6, 4, and 2. We're missing a 0. Now we go to another row or column. And we'll start with this one. We go with the left number and we go across on this row. And we see we already have an 8, 3, 1, 6, 0, 2, 7. So we are missing a 4 and a 5. But if we go up and down on this column, on the left numbers, we see that we already have a 5 down here on the left number, so a 4 must go here. And the remaining 5 will be here. Now we go to the right numbers, and we see we have 1, 5, 6, 3, 4, 2, 8, and we are missing a 7 and a 0. But if we go up and down on this column, we see we already have a 0 on the right numbers, so it must be a 7 that goes there. And the 0 must go over here. Now we go with this blank, we start with the left number and we see we have 3, 4, 2, 7, 8, 5, 6, and 1. So we are missing a 0. And on the right number, we check, we see we have 5, 7, 0, 4, 1, 8, 6, and 3. We're missing a 2. Let's find out, see, this row, it only has 2 blanks. We'll start with the left number, and we see we have 3, 5, 0, 2, 1, 6, and 4. So, we're missing an 8 and a 7. Now here we see that we already have an 8 on this column, so the 7 must go there. And here, we check this one, and we see that we are still missing the 8. And up in here, we don't have the 8, so the 8 can go there. Now we go to the right number, and we have a 4, 2, 3, 1, 8, 5, 6. So we are missing a 7 and a 0. But here, we check, we see we have no 7, but we have a 0. So the 7 can go there. And obviously the remaining 0 can go here. Now we go, let's start up here. We go to this one. We check the left numbers on this row, and we see we have 0, 2, 6, 8, 7, and 1. We are missing 3 numbers, but we go up and down on this column, and we see we have 0, 8, 2, 1, 5, 7, 3, and 2. We're missing a 4. When we go to the right number, we have 8, 1, 5, 2, 6, 7, 0, and 4, and we're missing a 3. Now we find the least amount of blanks on any row or column, and we use this row with only one blank. We go to the left number and we see we have 6, 1, 8, 3, 5, 4, 0, and 7. And we're missing a 2. And we go to the right number, and we check, and we see we have 8, 2, 3, 7, 5, 0, 6, 1. We're also missing the 4. Now, we can go up and down this column. And we see on the left numbers, we already have a 1, 6, 0, 2, 3, 8, 4, 7. And we're missing a 5. Now we go to the right number. And we see we already have 1, 3, 7, 4, 2, 0, 5, and 6. We're missing an 8. Now we go to this blank on this row. We'll start with the left number. We see we already have 1, 7, 8, 5, 6, 2, 4, 0. We're missing a 3. Okay, now we go to the right number. And we see we have 5, 4, 6, 8, 2, 7, 3, and 0. We're missing a 1. Now we can look for the least amount of blanks, and let's see, let's go with this one row. We go with the left number. We see we have 3, 0, 1, 7, 2, 4, 6, 5. We're missing an 8. Now we go with the right number. We see we already have a 3, 5, 7, 6, 0, 8, 4, 1, we are missing a 2. Okay. Now we need to find the row or column with the least amount of blanks. We can go with this column, with this blank, and go with the left numbers, and we see we have 0, 8, 4, 7, 6, 1, 3, and 5. We are missing a 2. Now we go with the right numbers, and we have 0, 5, 7, 2, 8, 3, 4, and 1. We're missing a 6. Now we go with this row, with this blank, and we go with the left numbers. We see we already have 2, 3, 1, 8, 4, 6, 5, and 0. And we are missing a 7. We go with the right number. We see we already have a 2, 7, 1, 5, 8, 4, 0, 6. We are missing a 3. Okay. Now we can go with this column in this blank, and we go with the left numbers. We already have an 8, 4, 0, 5, 6, 2, 7, and 1. We have a 3 that's missing here. We go with the right number, and we see we have 6, 2, 4, 5, 0, 1, 3, 7. We are missing an 8.
Now we can go find another row with least amount of blanks. And this one has, this column has two. This column also has two. And these both rows only have two. So we'll pick this one and go with the left numbers with this column. We have 3, 2, 7, 0, 6, 5, 8. So we are missing a 1 and a 4. So we go here and we see a 4 cannot go here because on this row we already have a 4 on the left numbers. So a 1 must go here and the 4 must go here. Now we go with the right numbers. We see we have 1, 3, 8, 6, 5, 7, and 2. So we're missing a 4 and 0. So we check on this row, we check the right numbers, and we have a 4 here, so a 4 cannot go here, so a 0 must go there. And the 4 can go down here. Now we go with this row, we check the left numbers on this blank, we see we have 7, 2, 4, 0, 3, 5, 1, 8. We're missing a 6. We go with the right numbers and we check and we see we have 2, 5, 1, 7, 3, 8, 3, 0, 4. We're missing a 6. Now we go with this blank and we check the left numbers. We see we have 1, 5, 7, 3, 6, 8, 4, 2, and we are missing number 0. Now we go with the right number and we see we have 3, 6, 5, 2, 0, 7, 4 and 8, we are missing number 1. And there you have it, puzzle is complete. Now there's 3 difficulty settings. Each face is 1 difficulty. This is the easiest one. The 3 faces would indicate the hardest setting. And that face name is Sipakna. Now there's no time limit in these games, but when you start the puzzle, there's a time that will start, and later on, in about 6 months, we will start having contests on YouTube and see who can finish these games the quickest, and we'll be awarded prizes. Thank you.